Good afternoon to all of you. The topic of my presentation is an option of resource conservation technologies for sustainable production analysis of potential impacts from Haryana. Next slide, please. So these are the basic objectives: to assess the socioeconomic profile, to assess the impact of zero tillage cultivator as well as laser land level on wheat production, to identify some constraints related to it, and to make some suggestions. So I will not go through all these socio-personal profiles. Next slide, please. Coming to the slides, if you see, if you classify the farmers on the basis of their own land holding and on the basis of total land holding, the category changes. And this shows very clearly that in Haryana and Punjab, taking land on lease basis for cultivation is very common practice. Next slide, please. We tried to find out communication behavior of the farmers. And in that existing context, we found that still in northern part, ADOs and agriculture officers are the prime source of information for the farmers. And still they rely on neighbors as well as their friends for information related to agriculture. But progressive farmers were also the main source of their information. Next, please. I tried to find out the mass media exposure of these farmers, and surprisingly, television is one of the major sources which has come up in the study area. And the second was mela and exhibitions, and we are always deliberating whether melas are required or not, such type of exhibitions are required or not. But if you see this finding, melas and exhibitions are rated as second most source of information for the farmers. Next, please. Then I tried to find out the distribution of farmers through which among which the study was conducted, and we found that there was a combination of all sorts of technology. The farmers gone for zero tillage, rotary tillage, or in combination of zero tillage plus rotary tillage, or in combination of all zero tillage and rotary tillage as well as laser land. Next slide. If you see the adoption of all the RCTs, whether it is zero tillage, whether it is jumbo happy seeder, whether it is rotavator or laser land leveler. There was not very remarkable scenario that which categories of farmers were opting which sort of technology. It means that all the technologies were adopted by majority of the category of the farmers, all the category of the farmers. Next, please. These are the same. Next, please. Then in case of the impact of zero tillage, it includes zero tillage machine as well as jumbo happy seeder. Next slide. And I tried to find out when zero tillage started, when happy seeder started, and there was not very clear cut trend when it touched the maximum number of farmers, when it was at lowest level of frequency. Next, please. But you see the parameters which were taken for the adoption impact of zero tillage technology. You can see in case of germination, in case of cost saving, time saving, these technologies having very good impact. And if you see the wheat flora, there was a mixed sort of response in both the categories of the farmers. Next, please. But if you see the profile of the soil in terms of soil fertility stresses, organic carbon content, or water retention capacity, in all the parameters, there was a very positive impact. One aspect also is that we are always facing with wheat, that there is an impact of terminal wheat hill. And in that case also, some of the farmers were very clearly responded that these technologies are capable of avoiding all those effects of terminal wheat. Next, please. So these are some possible benefits which farmers were telling about all the zero tillage as well as happy seeder technology. Next, please. So these were some of the constraints we can say, some of the difficulties we found that there are some difficulties in sowing when there is a lot of residue load, there is some blockage problems are there, some weed problems are there, rodents and some other problems are also there. So some suggestions they were given, and already Punjab government and Haryana government, already we have SMS mounted cultivator happy seeder, combined harvesters we have. And quality of machine was also an issue. Now we have very good machines available. Next slide. In case of rotary tillage, next slide. There was a very clear cut indication that during 2009 to 2012, this machine was catching up and the prevalence was low, both the rate of adoption was low, and suddenly it has gone down because of the emergence of new generation of turbo-emissor. Next, please. And on all the parameters, I can say in case of rotary tillage machine, in most of the parameters except cost of cultivation and germination, almost response was almost similar, the impact was almost similar as of in case of conventional tillage. Next, please. And most of the farmers were very, they were telling that they are getting more yield up to 2-3 quintals per hectare in case of rotary tillage. And some of the farmers were telling that there was an increase in logging in case of if you are going for rotary disc drill, say. Next, please. So these are some of the positive aspects which farmers were telling, there is cost saving, there is water saving, these are all innovations. So, next slide, please. And some of the suggestions they were telling that subsidies should be given to all the farmers, those who are needing this machine, not on lottery basis. And if some machine developed which is lightweight, so they can easily be drawn by 35 horsepower, 30 horsepower tractor. Next, please. In case of laser land leveler, I can say this is a boon for the farming community of almost throughout the country. And it has covered across the country. Next, please. If you see the impact of this technology, a lot of saving in terms of water quantity, time saving, as well as yield advantage is there because of uniform distribution of water, whether it is rice field, whether it is wheat field. Next, please. So, some positive aspects were there is a saving of water, equal distribution of water, cost saving, more in better quality, better rain quality, and increased area under cultivation. If you are making your field level, then definitely you are not going to make very small plots for irrigation. So you are saving. But the main concern was that the cost of machine is very high, and the rate of custom hiring is also high. Your field is very undulated, and availability of machine, it was that time concern, now it is not a concern of availability of machine. Next, please. So they were suggesting that subsidies should be given, and now this time we are facing a big challenge to address the stubble margin issue. And recently we had a meeting, and 1,000 crore have been earmarked for these machines, and on group basis, subsidy has been extended up to 80%. Earlier it was only 50% or 50,000 per machine. So this type of activities have been taken up. Next, please. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Any questions, clarification?
Sir, in case of turbo heavy series, the cost of machine is 1.55 lakh. For any small farmer who is having 10 acres, 10 acres or 5 acres of land, it is very difficult to purchase the machine only for wheat sowing, having a window of 25 days of utility of machine. So this was the basic reason.
Is it not available with the societies there in Haryana?
There are some preservation societies formed by the farmers. They are promoting it from the last 5-6 years. But still, you all are from EU. The machine itself took almost 10 years to be perfected. Now it is a perfect machine. Otherwise, there was a trial of each stage, and the machine was not that much perfect. Now it is a perfect machine.
Should we not add a suggestion that this machine should be through the cooperative society in any community purchase?
Sir,
it's one of the big, because you have found that in some years your level of adoption has gone too much, and then in another years it's went too high. It's not up to with respect to the subsidy of the government, when they have found the subsidy the adoption level. So rather, we should suggest that the cooperative societies on machines, especially such type of high cost machines.
Already they have started forming farmer groups, and on group basis 80% subsidy they are giving, and this is already started. At this time, before next season, I think machines will be available at village level.
Okay, I have two observations or suggestions. First is regarding extension services. You might have heard about the name of Sholt. transformation of traditional agriculture.
Okay.
He was honor of patron pride mine. Both are pro backward economists. Both are responsible for capitalization of all of the, all the sectors of the economy. Even that pro backward economist was in favor of that extension success should be provided by the government or non-profit making agencies. According to your study, even dealers are providing extension services. Then we can well imagine which type of service extension services is being provided to the actual cultivator. This government, the whole coming to power, was having one slogan: minimum government, maximum government. The evaluation of the policy of the government or the delivery of the government clearly indicates that it is minimum of the government, minimum of the governance that was less than their philosophy of the classical school of economic thought. If you will go that way, then there we will try to incorporate in your study. This is one point. Second, you are suggesting within the given framework, without realizing which problem we would face in the future or we are facing at present. Stubble burning. You have suggested different types of machines, different types of strategies. However, this paddy was imposed on Punjab, particularly Punjab and Haryana, only to fulfill the targets of central pool of food grains. I think the relevant suggestion here is to go for agro-climatic zones planning. Not Niti Aayog, rather planning commission. Agro-climatic, we can grow cotton, maize, wheat, agro-climatically suitable. We are facing a groundwater depletion problem and so many other problems.
Sir, regarding the machines, we have a very good...
First is extension services. Extension services should be provided by the government or non-profit agency.
Definitely, because...
In the study, even dealers are providing extension services.
Definitely, because any farmer is going for any pest control or any weed control, definitely they are asking
okay, okay, that
dealers.
Is, that is the information for the weed, however, policy implication is lagging. That they should not provide extension services, rather the universities, like the department or other government agencies should provide extension services.
Definitely.